What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm the doctor, and today we have some very exciting news. Yes, it is about the rental server program, or you might have heard it as RSP. DICE and EA have been extremely shoddy at best about trying to confirm or deny whether or not this is going to be implemented. For a few months now, we have all been relatively skeptical whether or not this game was going to really pack in the punch that most of the competitive and realistic communities needed. But before we get into that, I just want to thank Militim Christie for offering the insight on the potential leak. And yes, I mean leak. I literally mean leak today, just today. When you see this video, the date on the video, it happened literally today. Long story short, the Global Community Engagement Manager, his name is Forged, had posted not too long ago saying that had a meeting today on RSP and more to come. And this was in light of several documents and files, zip files to be specific, getting leaked out, I believe on Reddit, if I'm correct on that one. If somebody has information on that, then obviously in the comment section, just make that correction. But I'm very confident on Reddit there were links to zip files pertaining particularly to servers, private servers, expiration dates, renewal programs, just basic codexing of those specific functionalities within the RSP program that would be offered, of course, not by a third-party vendor like we've seen in Battlefield 4, but like we have seen in Battlefield 1, where EA is physically taking control of managing and maintaining those server programs offered to us. Now, interestingly enough, we come back to this monkey. Braddock512, big shout out to you, man. You have been absolutely no help in terms of rent-to-server programs. I'm sure many people have asked you, and I understand you're under contract and oath and all that crap, but my God, man. Of all the people who told me that they can't specify, you end up being the guy leaking this information. I don't know if you're like the anti-hero or like the hero that just unwittingly knows he's doing some good here, but I will give you the benefit of the doubt. You see here, it says, literally commented by Braddock512, our main man, Braddock. I don't believe it's going to be an option unless it's added to RSP private matches when it comes. Now, let's just hold up a second there. When it comes, that's basically a conditional. However, nobody really said anything about RSP. And the fact that he's just simply implying that it's going to be added to RSP means that, yes, we are getting RSP. I mean, that's just how it reads. That's the language used. It definitely confirms Battlefield 5 will be getting a rental server program. Now, I can't specify whether or not the servers that we will be allowed to rent will be allowed to be used in a public setting, or whether you'll have to publicly put it up with the rest of the server search, if you will. And in terms of when we expect to see a date, no date was mentioned, but this is still a huge step in terms of where we can go with this, simply because we have been waiting for months. The game itself is overall, it's good. There's some things that obviously they need to work on, and they've been working on a lot of bugs and performance issues. They've been working on a lot of critical things that would make this game not only more competitive, but somewhat more realistic. I mean, they do understand that there's people out there who want to taste essentially both aspects of the game. However your play style is, they are trying to cater to that. And when RSP drops, and this is my assumption on when we would expect a release date, but I'm guessing E3 of 2019 or E3 plays is when we will most likely get some idea, or at least get a confirmation on the release date of the RSP program, the rental server program, to Battlefield 5. But more importantly, it all comes down to, is this going to actually hold up? Like, for example, we've been waiting for so long. These communities, both competitive and realistic alike, most of these guys who have been dedicated Battlefield players, are we still going to retain those fans? Are we going to still retain those core players in these groups? I can't assure you. I can't I can't deny it. We might see a slight reduction in it, but at the same time, Battlefield 5, the multiplayer is still absolutely booming. Obviously, we're not seeing massive player turnouts, but we do have a really good base to start from and potentially grow the community out with new people who are new either to the game or, you know, even to the title. The series itself obviously has dragged over since, I guess we can call it the unofficial downfall of Call of Duty, but there's still a lot of opportunity here. So for all of you guys wondering where Milsim has been, we are just simply waiting for these features essentially to come to Battlefield 5 so that we can have the tools that we need to get our guys organized without the interference of just random people joining in the servers and really making it hard for us to conduct our usual business. And for those of you who are in the community as well, obviously you understand what we do takes a little time and effort. It also takes patience. So when you have people coming in and out and doing a lot of random stuff, it's really hard for us to do what we do best. But I hope this made your day at least slightly better. Just remember to hit that like button, that sub button. If you have any further questions, comments, or concerns, just put it down in the comments section. Once again, I just want to say a huge thank you to Militum Christie. You are an absolute lifesaver on this one. I was unfortunately unable to pick up on the radar that leaked information, but I did get a lot of traffic on Twitter about it, as well as on Facebook from some friends of mine. So after seeing that, and then of course getting the comment from you, Militum, huge shout out once again. So much. I mean, it's really a big help here. But we were able to actually basically confirm to you that we are expecting them to release it this year. In terms of when, I'm probably assuming sometime during the summer updates, which I believe there's two if I'm correct. And considering it's not content related, it can come in the form of a patch. But anyways, guys, I really hope that you found this video at least somewhat informative, somewhat helpful to you. Obviously, the future is looking bright for Battlefield 5. I'm just hoping that we, again, can retain that community, which I'm expecting we're going to have a lot of new faces because of a new game and a lot of new fans. But once again, this is a huge help, huge thumbs up. This is a really good sign that Milsim is definitely going to be making a return to our channel, and we're definitely going to be dedicating some time to it. But other than that, guys, if there's anything else you want to know, once again, down in the comment section, questions, comments, and concerns. Anyways, guys, you know how it goes. I'm the Doctor, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace out.